Hi everyone, Paul here from TechLink, and in today's video I want to show you how you can integrate the OpenAI's ChatGPT with Siri. Now, you probably saw a lot of people lately talk about ChatGPT and AIs in general. So I'm guessing you know what this is and what it can do for you. And also, if you are a long-term iPhone user, then you are probably familiar with Siri as well, which, as we all know, it sometimes has issues with understanding and processing our queries. But I'm not gonna talk about this. Instead, I wanna show you a way to integrate one with the other in order to obtain a kind of supreme AI that will help us in our daily life. To do that, we are going to use the Shortcuts app on our iPhone, but we'll get to that later on. What we actually need to do first is create an API key on the OpenAI's website. I'm going to leave some links in the description of this video, which will take you straight to the pages we are interested in. So just click on the first one and you will be taken to the OpenAI's website, where you are going to create an API key. But first, you will see a prompt asking you to create an account or login. So if you already have one, you can go ahead and log in. Or if you have a Google account, you can use that as well. It's up to you. Now, you should see a page that looks like this, which is the OpenAI's API key website. So we are going to create a new key. To do that, you just need to tap on this button that says create new secret key. And now you want to copy this text. So tap on it, copy, and then we're going to paste this into our shortcut. The next thing you want to do is add a new shortcut. So you need to tap on the second link in the description, which will open up this shortcut. And you can now save it into your Shortcuts app. So go ahead and add the shortcut. And once you've done that, you should see it in here. Now, what you wanna do next is edit this shortcut. So tap on the three dots icon, and we're going to change some of the fields in here. The first thing you wanna do is rename it. So you can call it whatever you like. Just keep in mind that we will use this command later on to activate it with Siri. So I'm just going to call it Siri Supreme. So Siri Supreme, tap done. The next thing you wanna do is tap on this box that says text, delete everything. And in here, we need to paste that API key that we previously copied. So paste. Finally, you need to scroll down till you see this tiny blue box where it says ask for text. And in here, we need to change this to whatever we want it to ask us. So based on your language or preference, you can put something like, how can I help you? Or what's up, gangsta? And this will be the response you get once you activate this feature. To finish, tap on done and done again. And now we can open it to run it for the first time. So just type in something in there like, how are you, or whatever. We need to do this to activate it so it doesn't prompt us every time we use it. Now press on done, and it will ask you if you allow it to connect. So allow it. You should see some kind of reply to whatever you wrote. And that's it. That's all we needed to get this started. And we can now use it with Siri. So if you go back to the main menu and use Siri like you normally do, you can ask it something like, what's the best place to live in London? And in most of the cases, it will just give you some links to pages related to your questions. But we don't want that. We just want a simple answer to our question. So if I press and hold this, Siri Supreme. What's up, gangster? What's the best place to live in London? And now we finally got an answer to our question rather than a bunch of links. So yeah, have fun with it. Now there would be another thing I want to show you. If, for example, let's say you don't want to use the voice commands. If you go back to the Shortcuts app, tap and hold the shortcut we just created, you will see a pop-up menu where you need to select details. And in here, you will see an option to add this to the home screen. So tap on add. And you will see it here next to your other apps. So like I said, if you don't want to use the voice commands, you can open it and type in here whatever you want. And you will get a text as a reply to your query. And that's pretty much it. If you found this video useful, then please give it a thumbs up. And if you are looking for a way to record videos with background music on your iPhone, then check out this video to find out how to do that.